This is my video on simple coding. So this is my Khan Academy account, and this is where I'm going to be teaching you to code simple processing JS, or processing JavaScript, which is a type of JavaScript that Khan Academy uses. To make a code, you press projects, and wait till it's loading. And if you've made a projects before, which I have, they'll be on here. Now I'm going to choose one, code demo, which I've made specially for this demo. Now, if you want to make a new code, would you press new program. If you don't have any codes on the screen, just press new project and it will make a code. Let's start with something simple, a rectangle. To do a rectangle, you write rect, then parentheses. X is, of course, the left and right position. Y is the up and down position. So you write, let's do 50, 50, which will be 50 to the right and 50 down. You can't make it bigger than 400 on either of them because it's only 400 pixels wide. So now, width is how big the rectangle is from its top left corner. Let's do 50. And height is how low it is from its top left corner, 50. Radius is how round the corners are. Let's do 0 for now. You don't have to write radius, and it'll automatically write a 0 if you just delete that. And now it'll automatically go to 0. Let's make it 50, and I'll turn around. Isn't that cool? So now let's color it with the fill command. It'll just write parentheses and it'll automatically fill it. The first said first number before the comma is red. Second is either yellow or blue, I'm not sure which. And the that one is the other color, the three primary colors. And you can mix them together to make a color, and all the shapes after that color will be like that until you change it. So let's make rect. So now let's make a circle. So let's color that circle yellow. Sorry, I'm talking so fast. I have a limited amount of recording time at the moment, so I have to make my videos very short. So after fill, you write ellipse to make circle. Then there's the X and Y position, which will make 600. The Y position will be 600. The W is how many pixels it is from the center, left, and right words. So let's say 50. And H is the same thing both as W, both up and down words. So let's say 50. End parentheses, that. But where's a circle? I mean, it should be on here. It's because as it's at 600, 600. This is only 400, 400. So let's lower it down by half. Now it's 300, 300. So now I'll be, center of the circle will be at 300, 300. For the rectangle, it's color for, not color, the first two numbers, the X and Y is the top left corner. So this top left corner is at 50, 50. This is the middle of the circle, it's 100. Now let's do a little more advanced shape. A triangle. We'll make it blue. So you write triangle, parentheses. Up there it says x1, which is the x position of one point. y1, which is the y position of that point. There's x2, which is the x position of that point. And y2, the x position of that other point. So let's write, I always do this, 50, 50, 50. So 3 50s and 3 5s. And if you do it right, it always appear in the top left. Then you can change things around to move it around. So you can do this. Now what if we want to get rid of that outline? That's called a stroke. So if you want to get rid of the stroke, you write no stroke, empty parentheses, semicolon. Everything after that will have no stroke unless you write stroke, and parentheses, or autofill it. Then you can choose the color of your stroke. Let's make it white. But what if we want it bigger? That's going to be difficult. So to make it bigger, we're going to have to write, stroke weight parentheses, how big it is. Let's make 50. And it'll make everything after that have 50 stroke. Inside and outside. So it's not that good since it's so big. So let's make it 5. There, now everything after that will have 5 stroke. Isn't that cool? So there's a bunch of other things we can do with code, like variables, which can store a number or other things into a variable. Let's do rectangle. So rect equals, let's say, 50. Oh, no. Mr. Oh, no, buddy says there's something wrong about it. I wonder why. Whenever there's something wrong with your code, he'll say what it is. And you click on him, you can press show me where. And when you do, it'll show you that line of code. I wonder what's wrong with this. He says, redefinition of rect. That's because we're telling it that rectangle doesn't mean to make rect doesn't mean a rectangle. It means 50. But that doesn't make sense. And it doesn't allow it. So you write it rectangle, which is not a type of code, equals 50. And then 50. Now, whenever you want to use 50, just write rectangle. And it'll, instead of saying there's something wrong with your code, it'll make it go to 50. You have to write this in every code. Like, if you started a new code and use rectangle in your rect, it won't work. So you had to make a new code. There's other uses for variables, like true or false, which isn't that important unless you're using if and else statements. You're going to use the numbers to help you animate with if and else statements. In draw functions, which you'll learn in intermediate level videos. So the circle equals true, which, like I said, won't do much. Or there's a third use, it's called picture equals function, parentheses, that, and it will make everything inside those brackets. Whenever you summon this variable, whole picture, it will make this happen. So let's write picture, empty those, that, and summon that. Or you can use X and Y to change it. It's for some other things, but that isn't that useful right now. So we can just leave parentheses empty. Now whenever that's called on, it will do that. Isn't that cool? So when we're done with that, you press save. If it's a new program, like what I'm doing now, let's call it demo 2, because I'm going to be using it later. Demo 2, and then save. It'll ask if you want to confirm that as your name, then you press save, and it will reload the page with this. Isn't that cool? That's my video on coding. Hope you liked it.